Hi, my name's Ahmed. I'm here with Consultech. This is the senior editor of Consultech. He's here to review the iPad 2 first-hand look. So let's go ahead and have a look.
Yeah, how's it going?
Good. How are you?
I'm great.
How's this new exciting product from Apple?
It's awesome. Have you actually seen it? iPad 2 is 33% thinner than the original, much more easier to hold in your hand. So if you're, you know, walking around, 33% lighter, get a, you know, less of an arm workout, but you know, it's okay.
It seems very similar to the iPad 1 though.
Oh, it definitely is. It's almost the same exact thing. The only thing is they actually put a camera right there on the top. We can't see it. It's really small, tiny, low VGA camera they put on there.
Really? They put a VGA camera on there?
No, I'm just kidding about that. It's actually a HD camera on there, and there's also one on the back. We can't lift it up too high because there's actually something holding it down.
An alarm will go off.
Yeah, so we can't set off the alarm. But it does have an A5 processor, as it says right here. Is that 2 times faster than the original iPad?
Let me ask you, is it noticeable compared to the iPad 1? Or is
it's up to 2 times faster. So it definitely depends on what you're doing. In most cases, you won't notice it unless you're doing like some serious video editing or something like that. Then you might notice it. But definitely you can see the rendering. It's slightly quicker than the original. So that's always good.
Okay, and what other differences are there between the iPad 1 and the iPad 2?
Other than that, that's practically it.
That's it?
Yeah.
All this hype just doesn't only 2 differences?
Pretty much. As far as physical differences, there's also a better graphics card in there as well. Other than that, it's practically the same thing. Other than the thinness, the processor, and the graphics, which is supposed to make a difference, but you know, we won't know. It's really the same.
So for people who don't have an iPad, do you recommend them, or people that already do have an iPad, do you recommend them upgrading to this iPad 2?
Absolutely not. Absolutely. That's a big waste of money if you do upgrade to this, because you're getting the same exact thing. You gotta be kidding me. You gotta spend your money somewhere else. You know, go check out that Motorola Zoom.
That's worth it.
Yeah, like the Motorola Zoom, that might be worth your money, you know, right there. That's something. But the cool thing is they do give you a case. And you know, if you like cases, you know, you definitely should upgrade. Because, you know, you get a nice little magnet.
So you can get the case.
Yeah.
It only fits the iPad 2.
Yeah,
it won't fit the iPad 1.
Yeah, exactly. It only fits the iPad 2. It's magnetic. Look, check it out. This is the video. Look how cool that is. Oh, wow. Look at that.
Turn it over.
Let's try to make it bigger.
See that case one more time.
Yeah, check out that case, man.
It just clips right on there.
It clips right on there. See that? But that only works with the iPad too. So if you fancy this, definitely go buy it. You know, spend another $500, $400.
I mean, if you've got money to throw, that's great.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
You might as well.
Might as well waste some money.
All right. Yeah. If you want the performance, Motorola Zoom, can't go wrong with it. You know, all day, every day.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.